Thank you. We'll begin our questions. My first question will be to Mr. Anderson. To paraphrase John Marshall, it is a peculiar duty of solicitors to say what the law is, at least within the Department of Interior. Congress writes the laws administered by the Interior Department, but the solicitor interprets them in the first instance. You do that in part by issuing legal opinions, which are binding on all of our bureaus and offices, at least until the courts say otherwise. 2 years ago, this committee held a similar hearing on your predecessor's nomination, at which I questioned him about the large number of his predecessor's legal opinions he had overturned. In fairness, I'm going to ask you the same question. I recognize that a new administration is entitled to reassess and reverse the policies of its predecessor within the limits of discretion afforded by the law. But what standard of review do you apply in deciding whether to overturn a prior interpretation of the law?
Thank you, Senator Manchin. I've carefully considered, the role of the solicitor based on my experience within the department, both working for John Leschi and as an observer, as an academic, and since my 4 months as the acting solicitor. And, the number one rule is that we have to follow the laws as written by Congress. And so when there is a solicitor's opinion written by a predecessor, whether he or she is a Democrat or a Republican, they need to be reversed when they're plainly inconsistent with existing law. And an example of one opinion that I reversed was an interpretation by Solicitor Giorgiani involving the Migratory Bird Treaty Act that was struck down by a federal district court in New York. And so we have reversed that opinion in accordance with the court decree. Secondly, we look at these opinions sort of in the same way that we look at regulations. We evaluate whether or not they are consistent with the overriding law and regulations or are arbitrary and capricious. So we give some deference, but we look very searchingly at the rationale for a particular opinion. We also look at whether or not a particular opinion is based on and intended to facilitate policies that have now been rejected. And I've got an example of that involving a solicitor's opinion from Solicitor Giorgiani that involved implementation of the energy dominance executive order adopted by President Trump that's been reversed by President Biden. And so we got rid of that order or that solicitor's opinion, and we'll substitute new advice based on implementation of the policy.
Let me say thank you, because I feel that you're going to be pretty precise and use the law rather than just use your own opinion. Thank you very much. Ms. Esnos, during the last Congress, we achieved what I believe is one of the great conservation success stories, first by permanently reauthorizing the Land and Water Conservation Fund as part of the public lands package signed into law in 2019, and then by providing permanent mandatory funding for LWCF in the Great American Outdoors Act. Enactments of those bills was only made possible because of strong, truly strong bipartisan support in both the House and Senate, and I think it's important to maintain that bipartisan support. I was disappointed that the previous secretary was initially less than forthcoming about which projects would be funded and impose new conditions and restrictions on the program without any congressional input. I was glad to see that President Biden's administration has revoked those secretarial orders so that the program would be managed as it has been in the past. So if confirmed, and I know you will you commit to working with the Congress to ensure that the criteria of the Great American Outdoors Act is developed in an open public process that recognizes priority funding needs of all states?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And I, like so many Americans, are so grateful for the action of the Congress last year. LWCF full funding truly is a game changer. And if I am confirmed, implementing that program, squeezing the maximum value out of every single dollar and getting those dollars to work on the landscape will be a top priority.
Well, we just want to make sure that we're involved in that, because all of us have projects, and we want to make sure everyone's treated fair.
Absolutely, Senator, I agree.
Ms. Trujillo, if confirmed, you will oversee the Bureau of Reclamation. Reclamation manages nearly 500 dams and over 300 reservoirs in 17 western states. It provides water to one out of every five western farmers and more than 31 million people across the West. It irrigates more than 10 million acres of land and generates over 40 billion kilowatt hours of electricity each year. The Bureau of Reclamation runs on water, and our water supplies are increasingly at risk throughout the West as temperatures rise. Precipitation declines, droughts lengthen, snowpacks decrease, and melts earlier, and catastrophic wildfires increase runoff. The Bureau, my question would be, the Bureau of Reclamation published a climate change adaptation strategy in 2014, but hasn't reported on its progress since 2016. Is enough progress being made to confront these challenges, and how do you plan to address the challenges if you are confirmed?
Thank you, Senator Manchin, for recognizing the importance with respect to the Bureau of Reclamation's management authority of water in the West. The approach to climate change is part of the priority actions that we are undertaking, and I have strong respect for the engineers and scientists and managers at Reclamation who are developing those plans. They have tools available through the Water Smart program and other drought relief programs, but we are continuing to look for additional resources and additional input from members of Congress, members of the public, and our strong foundation of stakeholders to improve upon our existing resources. We look forward to working with you on those issues.
Thank you. Now we'll turn to Senator Barrasso for his questions.